हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू स्टैंडर्ड 10 सब्जेक्ट मैथमेटिक्स चैप्टर 3 पैर ऑफ लीनियर इक्वेशन 2 वेरिएबल्स। दिस इज लेक्चर नंबर 9। इन बिफोर दिस लेक्चर वी हैव सीन मेथड्स ऑफ ग्राफिकल मेथड टू सॉल्व द पैर ऑफ लीनियर इक्वेशन, देन सब्स्टिट्यूशन मेथड, देन एलिमिनेशन मेथड वी हैव सीन। नाउ वी हैव द क्रॉस मल्टीप्लिकेशन मेथड। इन दिस मेथड हाउ टू सॉल्व द पैर ऑफ गिवन इक्वेशन, दैट वी विल सी। And this given example we are taking for that. Example 14 is from a bus stand in a Bangalore. If we buy 2 tickets to Maleshwaram and 3 tickets to Yeshwantpur, the total cost is rupees 46. But if we buy 3 tickets to Maleshwaram and 5 tickets to Yeshwantpur, the total cost is 74. Find the fares from the bus stand to the Maleshwaram and to the Yeshwantpur. So, fare from bus stand to Maleshwaram, bus stand is of Bangalore. So, Bangalore to Maleshwaram fare we want, and Bangalore to Yeshwantpur fare we want. We want to find here. So, in solution, let the fare from Bangalore to Maleshwaram is rupees X. Fare means the cost of one ticket from Bangalore to Maleshwaram is X. And the fare from Bangalore to Yeshwantpur is rupees Y. So as per the given question, in first condition, how many tickets we bought for Maleshwaram? 2 tickets. If 1 ticket fare is X, 2 tickets fare will be 2X, that is written, plus 3 tickets to Yeshwantpur. If 1 ticket of Y, 3 tickets to Yeshwantpur will be 3Y. So 2X plus 3Y will be the total cost of total 5 tickets, which was from Bangalore to Maleshwaram 2 tickets and Bangalore to Yeshwantpur is 3 tickets. Total cost is 46 given in the question, so equals to 46. Second statement, if we buy 3 tickets to Maleshwaram, so as per X, it will be 3X cost, plus 5 tickets to Yeshwantpur will be 5Y. So total of 3X plus 5Y is 74 given, that is it. Now, this equation can be written as in the standard form. This plus 46 on the left side, if I take, it will be 2x plus 3y minus 46 equal to 0. And this also the same way, 74 on the left side, you have to take 3x plus 5 minus 74 equal to 0. This is the very first condition for the cross multiplication method to use, that your equation should be in the pure standard form. This is equation 1 we will consider, and this is equation 2. Pure standard form, that means, general form, that means X term, Y term and then constant equals to 0, it should be in this form only. Then X term, Y term and constant term equals to 0, this form only. That is, the condition is, we have to be in this form only. A1X plus B1Y plus C1 equal to 0, that is the general form. And A2X plus B2Y plus C2 equals to 0. This form is necessary there. Okay? So this 46 constant is taken on left. Here also the constant taken in the left. This condition is must fail. Then only it will be applied forward. So now in this general form we have both the equations. Now how to apply the cross multiplication method, that is, here we have to write in 3 parts, and all the 3 parts we have to show them equal. X upon something we will write equals, Y upon equals 1 upon. What we write X upon, that we have to see here. When we are going to write below X, the fraction forms we will write. So X upon, what we write, you hide this equation in that X. X terms we have to hide. So what are the coefficients of Y and constant is 3 minus 46 and 5 minus 74. This we can see. These numbers we have to write over here. Below X. Below X what we have to do? Hide these X terms. And the coefficient of Y and constant term we have to write. That is 3 and minus 46. Here we will write below X. 3 and minus 46. This up from the equation 1 and from the equation 2. Hide X and plus 5 and minus 74, that here we will write somewhat down, minus 74. जिसमें वी हैव टू प्लेस द वैल्यूज. सो बिलो x वी विल राइट द वैल्यूज which will be the values, the coefficient of y and the constant from the first equation, from the second equation down there. Similarly, upon y, we will hide y. We will hide this time y. So what we can see, the coefficient of 2x is 2 and constant is minus 46. And in second number, coefficient of x is 3 and constant is minus 74. Below y, when we are writing, you remember that we will not write this to first the coefficient is. We will write constant first. Means reverse order we will have to follow here. So minus 46 we will write first, and then hide the y is the coefficient of x is 2 that we will write. Similarly, the equation number two also will do the same. Hide y minus 74 constant we will write first. And quotient of x will write then 3 this way. So this way we have a number place below x and below y. And now below 1, we will hide the constants. Hide the constants. We will write down there the quotient of x and quotient of y in straight order now. So in below x, straight order, below y, reverse order, and below 1, again the straight order. So it is quotient of x and y will write because we have to hide this constant. So here 2, 3, 3, 5. 2, 3 from first equation we will write up there here. And 3, 5 from the equation number 2 here down we will write here. So this is very important here to place the values below x and below y and below 1. Below x, once again, understand what you have to do. Hide x and the quotient of y and the constant, quotient of y and the constant we have to write. Below y, hide y, here constant first, then quotient of 2, constant first and quotient of x, this way. Below y we have to write in reverse order, here constant is first and then quotient of 2, quotient of x, that way. And below 1, hide constant, quotient of x and quotient of y, 2, 3, 3, 5, that way you have to place all the values A1, B1, C1 and A2, B2, C2, that way, all the numbers we have to write. Then what to do? As its name is cross multiplication, so we will multiply these numbers cross. These two numbers first you multiply. So 3 into minus 74, that we will do here. 3 into minus 74. Then minus of the method. These two multiply we have shown here. Then minus of the method we have to do. And then multiply these two cross. 5 into minus 46. And this will be equal only. Or this. Similar way here also. These two multiply we have to show first. Below y minus 46 into 3. And minus of the method sign. Then we have to show the multiplication of these two cross. That is minus 74 into 2. Equals it is again equal. Below 1 it is the same. These two multiply will be first. That is 2 into 5 minus of method. Then these two multiply second part. 3 into 3. This way we have to show them cross multiplying form. Now we will do the multiplication. We will simplify the given things. So this minus plus minus 3 into 74. 3 4s are 12. 1 carry 3 7s are 21 and 1 22. And this minus minus plus multiply 5 into 46. 5 6s are 30. 0 3. 5 4s are 20 and 3 22. So this is the simplification below x. Similarly below y we have to simplify. Equals it will be always minus 46 into 3. So plus minus minus 3 6s are 18. 1 3 4s are 12 and 1 13. So it is minus 130. then this is minus minus plus 74 2s are means 2 4s are 8 and 2 7s are 14. This is 148 equals one amount the same way 2 5s are 10 minus 3 3s are 9. This will be able to simplify. Now more simplification will be x upon 230 plus and minus 220 will give us 230 plus and minus 222 will give how much it will give only 8 will be remaining down equals to here plus 148 and minus 138 will give 10 equals 10 minus 1 will give 1. When we have x upon this simplified part, y upon also the simplified part, 1 upon simplified part, totally simplified all the values now. So now the next step is we have to compare the x values with the 1 values and y with the 1. Both x and y will be compared with 1. So this way, here we will have x upon 8 equals to 1 upon 1 is 1, we can write, and y upon 10 also compared with this one. 1 upon 1 is 1. You can write 1 upon 1 also or 1 only. Then you know across multiply x into 1, x 8 into 1, 8. So x equals to 8. And here y into 1, y equals to 10, 1s are 10. So y equals to 10. So x equals to 8 and y equals to 10. Here we have this is the cross multiplication method. It's very easy, but we have to write all the numbers very carefully. First, we have to take the given equations, pair of given equations in the general form only. Then we can write x upon, y upon, 1 upon, all the values. How to write that we have seen. You see the video 2-3 times, and you will be confident how to write the numbers below x and below y and below 1. Then how to cross multiply them. First, we have to show them. Then you have to cross multiply and simplify, and the simplest form is compared with the x and 1, y and 1, and we will get the value of x and y. So this way x and y we got. What is x over? It is the fare from Bangalore to Maleshwaram. So final answer we have given here, therefore the fare from Bangalore to Maleshwaram is rupees x, that is 8, and the fare from Bangalore to Yeshwanthpur is y, that is rupees 10. So this way both the fares we have found using cross multiplication method. So this is very simple, you can see that. And next examples and next exercise 3.5, you have to apply this method because this exercise is based on cross multiplication method. Now example 15 next we have, for which value of p does the pair of equation given has a unique solution? So pair of equations are given 4x plus py plus 8 equal to 0 and 2x plus 2y plus 2 equal to 0. These pair of equation is given and we have to find the value of p. Which value of p? For that the pair of equations must have unique solution. So in solution here, if we compare with this general form, this first equation is compared with a1x plus b1y plus c1 equal to 0 and 4x plus p1 plus 8 equal to 0. So this coefficient of x is a1, coefficient of y is b1 and constant is c1. In second equation this is a2, b2 and c2. So here we have done a1 is 4, a2 is 2, b1 is p and b2 is 2. For unique solution, in the first 2-3 lectures we have seen when the when the pair of line gives unique solution, the condition is a1 upon a2 is not equals to b1 upon b2. This condition we know for the ratio for having a unique solution. a1 upon a2 is not equal to b1 upon b2. Place the values here. a1 upon a2, that is 4 upon 2, is not equal to as it is. b1 upon b2 is p upon 2. Upon 2 upon 2, both the side cancel. So what we have, 4 is not equal to p, that is p not equal to 4. What is suggest? P not equal to 4 means except 4, for all the values of
p, it will have a unique solution. So that is here for all values of p except 4, because p is not equal to 4. So except 4, all the values of p, the given pair of the equation has a unique solution. Except 4, it will give always a unique solution for the value of p. Next example 16 is, for what value of k will the following pair of linear equations have infinitely many solutions? So pair of linear equations is given here, kx plus dy minus k minus 3 whole equals to 0, 12x plus ky minus k equal to 0. Here the value of k we want to find out for infinitely many solutions. So for infinitely many solutions, the condition is, for unique solution, this condition you know, a1 upon a2, b1 upon b2 is not equal. That we have used in here, because it was for unique solution. For infinitely many solutions, this condition we have in our theory. A1 upon a2 equals to b1 upon b2 equal to c1 upon c2. This theory we have. So, again by comparing this pair of equations by this general form, this is a1 and a2. Coefficient of x are e1 and e2, coefficient of y are b1 and b2, and constant terms are c1 and c2. Place all the values. So e1 upon e2 is k upon 12 equals b1 upon b2 means 3 upon k equals c1 upon c2 means minus k minus 3 bracket upon minus k. This minus to minus we cancel up and down. Now to get the value of k, first we have compared first two. A upon 12 equals to 3 upon k. If we compare first two ratio, because they are equal, so in cross multiply, you know, k into k, k square equals to 12, 3 are 36. If k square equal to 36, what will be the value of k? Value of k means root of 36, because k square is 36. To get k, we have to find root square root. Square root of 36 plus 6 or minus 6, both we may have. K equal to plus or minus 6, that means k equals to 6 or k equal to minus 6, both it may be. This value of k we have obtained from first two given ratio. Now we will compare the second two ratios also. In second two ratio, we can write 3 upon k equals to 3 minus 3 upon k. This is also given, so we can compare these two. Well, when simplifying this, cross multiply again, k into 3k equals k into k minus 3 is k into k, k square minus 3 into k, 3k. So it is k square as this plus 3k on the right side, minus 3k and minus 3k will be minus 6k equals to 0. So k is common from both of this, k into k minus 6 equal to 0. It shows that k equal to 0 or k minus 6 equal to 0. K equal to 0 or k minus 6 equal to 0 will give k equal to 6. So in both the cases, this is the case 1 we have seen, this is the case 2 we have seen, in which here we are getting k equal to plus 6 or minus 6, here we are getting k equal to 0 or 6. So what is common in both? K equal to 6 remains in both. So that is the confirmed value of k. So in both k equal to 6 we have, that will be the value of k for what? For what? The pair of given equation will have infinitely many solutions. So k equal to 6 we have to consider, because it comes in both the condition common. So this way some condition based examples we have seen, and you will find this type of questions in exercise 3.5. So these examples we have done. So what is your homework? You write this first in the class work, and then your homework is to complete exercise 3.5. In which elimination, cross multiplication method is we have to apply in the question given, and if some questions are related to this, find the value of p or find the value of any constant, and for being unique solution, for being infinitely many solutions, for being no solution also, we have the question. We have to apply the same rules which we have seen in the previous lectures. For unique solution, you know, a1 upon a2 is not equal to b1 upon b2, that way we have gone and we find the answer. For infinitely many solutions, that relation we have to write and find the value. And similar way we have to go, if asked in the question, as per that we have to write the conditions and then we can find the given.